In this video, I show you how to use Azure Automation and Event Grid to automatically copy Blob files from Azure Storage to a local file system. Hello everyone, my name is Travis and this is Seraltos. I posted a video a while ago on keeping local files in sync to Azure Blob Storage with AZ Copy. I'll post a link to that video up here someplace. In response, AzureM asked about using Azure Functions or web jobs to do the opposite, copy files from Blob Storage to a local file system. Thanks for the question. I can't promise to help everyone in these videos, but it seemed like an interesting challenge, so I decided to give it a try. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe, and for those who have, thank you. Here's the problem I'm trying to solve. I have an Azure Storage account. When a new Blob file is placed into the account, I want to copy that file to my local file server. First thought is to use web jobs or an Azure function. The problem I ran into is there is no easy way to move or copy that data into a file system behind a firewall. I did do some quick research on this. It could be possible with a web job and a relay hybrid connection, or with VNet connectivity on a web app or Azure function, but that would require coding beyond PowerShell, and that's just not something I'm able to do. Instead, I'm going to stick with what I know for this challenge. That's Azure Automation, and Azure Automation is well suited for this. At a high level, here's how it works. A new file arrives in the storage account. That triggers Event Grid. Event Grid sends a webhook to start an Azure Automation runbook, passing details along the way as JSON payload. Azure Automation starts the runbook on the hybrid worker inside the network. The runbook downloads the file to the local file share. You will need to have Azure Automation configured with a hybrid worker if you want to follow along. I have a playlist that covers that. The link is above. You will also need an Azure Storage account. I have an overview of Azure Storage accounts published here. Of course, I'm going to start this at the most logical place, the middle. I need to first create and publish a runbook. Runbook code isn't important at this point, but what is important is that the runbook is published so I can get the webhook. I'll come back and finish the runbook in a later step. Once the runbook is in place, I create the webhook. The webhook has a special token that authenticates and triggers the runbook. Once I have the webhook, I can configure Event Grid to trigger the runbook. The webhook has a JSON payload with details such as file name and container. I'll use this in the runbook for the download command. The runbook is configured to run on a hybrid worker in my network. This gives me the ability to copy the file to a local file system. Lastly, I'll put it all together. Now, when a new file is added to Blob Storage, the runbook will download that file to a local file system. Let's get started by creating the runbook. Okay, buckle up everyone, it's demo time. Here I am at the Azure portal inside my Azure Automation account. And the first thing I'm gonna do is add a new runbook. I'll give it a name, CIR Blob Demo. Of course, you can give it whatever name you would like if you're following along. I'm gonna select PowerShell and I'll create. Okay, now that it's created, I'm going to edit it. And I'm just going to add some code. As I mentioned before, the goal right now is just to get the webhook. But I'm going to paste some code in that will help me see what's getting passed in. This code simply grabs the input that's coming in from the webhook and then writes it to the output stream. I'm going to save and publish. And we'll come back and edit this in a few steps. But for now, all I'm looking for is to be able to do the add webhook. First, I'm going to create the webhook, and I'll give this a name. I'll just call it Blob Webhook. I'm going to make sure it's enabled. I'm going to set the date for a year out. Keep in mind that if you're doing this in production, you'll want to make note of that expiration date, because it will quit working once that expires. I'm going to copy the URL. I'm going to use this in a later step, and you can't come back and get this. Copy and paste it someplace safe. The URL does have a token in it. With that token, anything can trigger this runbook. So it's a security object, and you can't retrieve it later. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to configure parameters. So I'm not going to pass any parameters in, but I'm going to select hybrid worker. As I said in the slides, you need to run this on the hybrid worker. That way you have access to the file system behind the firewall. And again, if you're not sure what a hybrid worker is, go back to my Azure Automation playlist and watch it. I have plenty of details there. So next I'm going to click OK and create. Next I'm going to go into my storage account. And I'm going to find the storage account that I set up for this demo. There it is. If I go into Blobs, you can see I have a container here called CIR Demo. That's where I'm going to upload my files. Although the way this works, it doesn't really matter. Any blob that's uploaded to this storage account will get downloaded locally. Next, I'm going to go into Events. This is where Event Grids is found. I'm going to go into More Options and Webhook. So this is where I'm going to set up Event Grid to fire a webhook every time a new file is uploaded. So I'll just call this Blob Event. I can leave the schema. I can leave the topic details. I do need to change the event type. I only want this to fire when a new blob is created, so I'm going to uncheck the delete. Under endpoint details, I'll go to webhook, and it's going to ask me to select an endpoint. Here's where I'm going to paste that webhook, and then confirm selection, and create. So that's going to create my webhook in Event Grid. And next, I'm going to go to access keys. These are blurred out for now. You're actually probably going to be able to see them in a little bit, but that's okay because this will be long gone by the time you're watching the video. But I'm just going to copy the key, the first key, and paste that someplace as well. I'll come back to that later, but you will need this key for a future step. So next, I'm going to go into Storage Explorer Preview. I'm going to go to my blob container. I'm going to go into the container I set up for this test, and I'm going to upload a file. I've got a test one on my desktop, and I'll upload. Okay, so that's been uploaded. Now I'm going to go back to Azure Automation, go into my automation account, and under jobs, and let's see if we have a job running. Yep, there it is. So what did I do? I uploaded a new file to that container using Storage Explorer, and as soon as that happened, that webhook fired, and that's running a job in Azure Automation, and we're going to see the results of that job in just a second. Okay, now it's completed, and we're going to look at output, and there it is. There's the output, so it did pass along the data I need. I'm going to go into input, though, and I'm going to just select this. This is the data that came in, and if I copy that, this is all JSON data, so I'm going to go to VS Code, create a new file, and we'll just call this data.json. I'm going to paste that in, and I'm going to format it. There. So now we can see the data that was passed in. This is handy if you actually want to see what's being passed between the webhook and the actual runbook. If we scroll over, we can see some information that's kind of helpful. So under subject, you can see we have data which is blob services, default, containers, and that's the container name. Also, if we go to URI, I think it is, let's see here, URL. Here it is. We can see that the very last is the file name. So I'm going to use this data to build the final runbook. So with that, let's go in and build the runbook. Here I am at the finished runbook. I wasn't going to make you actually watch me type all this out. That would have been pretty horrible. Maybe someday I'll set up a Twitch stream, but for now, I'm just going to give you the final product, and I will make this available, so you don't have to try to copy all this down. It'll be on my GitHub page, and you can find a link to that in the video description. So first, I have the parameters just like before, so it's capturing that data as it's passed into the runbook. I have some error control in here. I'm just setting the error action default to whatever it is when it starts. Next, I'm going to identify the local path. So this is the path that the file will get downloaded to. You can change that if you need to, but this is going to copy everything to the C blob directory on the local server. Storage account name, that's the name of the account we're targeting. You'll need to create a runbook for every storage account you want to use this against. Next is a storage access key. So this is the security token or the key that we copied previously. We need that to actually interact with a storage account in this runbook. I don't want to put the key in my actual code. So I've got a get automation variable and a blob copy key. So let's set up that variable in Azure Automation. Here I am in the storage accounts. I'm going to go to variables. I've got a handful in there already, but I'm going to add a variable. I'm going to leave it as string. I'm going to set the value as the actual key. The value is the key that we copied before. And again, I'm not going to blur this out. It's going to be gone by the time I post this. Important, click yes to encrypted and create. Here we can see it's been created with an unknown type because it's encrypted. So let's get back to VS Code. Okay, so now we have the storage account key set. The great thing about doing it this way is you can call that same key for other runbooks. And if that key ever needs to be rotated, you only have to rotate it or change it in the one encrypted variable. You don't have to go into each runbook. Next, I'm going to set the storage context. And you'll see I'm using the try, catch, and then sometimes finally block for error control. What happens is it's going to try a command, and if it hits the error action stop, it's going to write the error to the error output stream, and then stop the script. So if you need more information on that, there's a great book on powershell.org. It's an e-publication on error control. But for now, just know that's what that's about. Here's the command, though, that I'm running. It's creating the storage context. So that's going to give me the access permission to log in and pull that file down. Next, I'm taking the webhook data that was input, and I'm going to the request body portion of that, and I'm converting it from JSON. And that's going to be in a variable called request body. And again, more error control. So here what I'm doing is I'm getting the request body.subject, and we looked at that before. Let's find that. Here's subject. So here's what I'm dealing with right now in this little section of code. And what I did is I used the split command to split that based on the forward slash. So you can see here, it's going to split all these items up. And on the 1, 2, 3, 4, the 4 is the container name. And I think that's going to be pretty consistent no matter what's passed in. It will always be the container name will be the fourth object in that string. So I'm telling it the container is going to be the subject array number 4. I guess technically that may be the fifth because the array may start with a 0. Anyway, it works. The next command finds the actual file name. So I'm grabbing data again from the request body, and I'm looking for that URL. And the storage account name is a variable, as well as the container. And what I'm doing is just stripping all this off, because I'm doing a replace command, and I'm replacing it with nothing. So that's going to leave me with the file name. If the file name is in a path, it's going to leave the path in the file name. And here we can go down, and the next command is I'm doing a test to see if that local file path exists. So again, this is the local file, the C, what did I call it? Let's scroll up and take a look. C blob. So it's going to test to see if that path exists, and if not, it's going to create it. Okay, here I've got a big block of write outputs that I was using for testing. I'm going to leave them in there, I think. You can uncomment it if you're curious on what everything is coming out as. It's helpful if you're trying to identify, you know, what is actually being passed back and forth. But for production, I don't really need it because I know it works. The final step is going to actually run the copy command. It uses the get az storage blob content command and passes in all the variables that we've set up so far, along with a context that was created to give us access to that storage account. I have a couple notes that I want to point out. For this one, I'm using the AZ module. If you're using the Azure RM, the default that comes with Azure Automation, you'll want to change the command to get Azure storage blob content instead of AZ storage blob content. Also, if you are using the AZ command, I had a problem where I was getting illegal character and path error. And it took me a while to figure out what was going on. But I've got two links here that reference the issue. And what happens is I had to add a file called orchestrator.sandbox.exe.config. And it's all outlined in these two articles. It's possible that you won't get that by the time you watch this. It may have been fixed, but it's a bug within the AZ module. Also, one other thing that I kind of skipped over, but I want to go up and make sure we don't overlook it. Here, under the storage context, I'm using the AZ command. So these are two locations. If you're using the default modules that come with Azure Automation, you'll need to change them from AZ to the older command. So with that, let's copy it in and paste it into that runbook. And I'll just paste that in. There are 100 different ways to manage this, or at least 3, but I'm doing the old school copy and paste. So I'm going to save it and publish it. So that runbook is done. Let's trigger it by adding another file to the storage account. So I'm going to go back into the storage account, and I'm going into Storage Explorer. This is just a way to emulate a file appearing into that storage account. And I'm going to upload a file. Let's see if the job ran. So I'm going to go back to Azure Automation, go back into my automation account, jobs, and it did run. It ran on the domain group. And we can see the input, output, errors. There's no errors, so that's a good sign. Next, I'm going to go into the hybrid worker that it ran on. Okay, here it is. Here you can see I'm at the C drive. I'm going to go into Blob. And there it is. So let's upload another one and just see if that works again. Back to storage accounts. Go into my storage account. Go into Storage Explorer. I'm going to upload again. This time I'm going to select test 3 and I'm going to overwrite the file if it exists and upload. There you can see it just appeared. That indicates it works. So we've got a working runbook. I want to test one more thing. I'm going to create a new folder. We'll click OK and I'm going to upload test 3 to that. Let's see what happens back on my hybrid worker. Look at that, it created the folder, and there's the file. So not only does it copy new files that occur in that storage account, but it will also create the directory structure if you add folders and add files. So that's a success. Every time a file is uploaded to the storage account, it's downloaded onto the local machine. There's a lot of things you could do to configure this, like specify maybe a container as a parent folder instead of having everything just drop into one local file path defined in the variable. But hopefully this gets you started in understanding how storage account, event grid, runbooks, and hybrid workers can all work together to automate some pretty common tasks. That's it for the demo. Thanks everyone. I hope you found this helpful. Don't forget to subscribe and thanks for watching.